Hey Aaron, this is Keaton Everett with ABC, going over your pitching video from camp. We're going to go through and talk a little bit about your mechanics and kind of talk a little bit about sort of what we like to see at each sort of spot in your mechanics. You know, what we like to see at the start, at your foot strike, and sort of how you're releasing. We'll go through and break it down and make sure, you know, you're in a nice, healthy position and delivering the ball with as much power, you know, with as much efficiency, consistency, and keeping yourself healthy, all right? So basically, right off the bat, we're just going to start and talk a lot about how you're starting, sort of that initial start to your mechanics. This is going to be big for you, is to slow yourself up a little bit, not tempo-wise, but I mean, and slow yourself up momentum-wise, all right? I'm going to draw a box here over your head. All right, and then we're going to kind of click through here and watch right when this leg starts coming up. All right, you're just getting going right out in the gate. All right, you're seeing your head drop sort of right as that leg's coming up. All right, what we want to try to see you is staying over that back leg a little bit longer and staying a little bit taller. All right, your first initial setup is pretty good. All right, we want to try to have our weight over that back foot a little bit. All right, so then as you come and lift, what we want to try to see is that the height of your leg kick, which for you is about right here. All right, one thing too, it looks like you're kind of looking at the ground. Make sure you want your eyes on that target the whole time. But at this point, we want to try to see your head at that same point back here, and we want to try to see you a little bit more taller over that back leg. You can kind of see how you've dropped out. You've started to bend that back leg a little bit. All right, you can see how this front foot's kicking out in front, and all this is doing is this is sort of creating you know, losing this back leg a little bit and creating sort of some inefficiencies and kind of taking away power from you. And at this point, we want to try to see you, like I said before, trying to stay over a little bit more of that back leg, staying a little bit taller, but we're going to try to see this foot and this knee get back over that back foot a little bit more so you're closed off, all right? Because basically what we want, the main driving force of everything is our hips. We want to try to have our hips go forward first, all right? And we want to try to have them lead. We don't want to try to see this foot out in front, all right? We want to try to see that back probably over here. You know, the front of your hips probably going to be about right here, all right? And your back head's a little bit farther there. So it's just kind of like you're basically sort of creating this sort of this V here, bending that back leg. We want to try to stay taller a little bit and get this back foot closed off a little bit more so you can keep your hips closed so you can get going down the mound with a little more power on that backside, right? You can see how here, you know, your foot is just kind of staying up and out, and it's almost like, you know, you're kicking something right here, whereas when we're kind of back here, we basically kind of want to see our hips lead, you know, down the mound a little bit more. So then as you're probably about right here, you know, our foot's still behind our hips. All right, so your front leg's just kind of getting out in front, and you're just losing a little bit of that power on that backside. So we just got to try to have you stay back a little bit longer so you're leading more with your hips. You're using that lower half because that's where that power and velocity come from, are your hips. All right, so that's just sort of that one sort of real quick. It'll be real easy for you to fix. And what you can see is when you kind of kick this leg out, if you key in on your glove here, is you're going to see your glove's late and never really gets extended. All right, you can see your glove staying on your chest, and it really never gets out over that front foot a little bit. And then you can see how you're landing really big on your heel, which isn't too bad, but you can start to see your foot pop open. All right, and all that's showing us is that you're landing with your hips open. All right, here's probably, looks like this frame, we might call that foot strike right there. Kind of tough, it might be in between these frames. All right, so because you've kind of kicked out, because you kind of lost that front side, you can see you're landing with almost a straight knee to your ankle. All right, you get pretty good extension, but we want to try to see a little bit more out with that front leg. All right, we don't want to see that knee over that ankle. We want to try to see you still staying in that front leg, because when you're landing out over that front foot, what that's showing us is that your weight's not here. Your weight's basically out here, and it's not in your hips anymore. All right. Glove-wise, it's decent. Like I said, it's kind of dragging a little bit. When you get that out a little bit more, it's going to help you get a little bit more extension, and sort of store up a little bit more power in that lower half. And so then through that release point, you're going to see this front shoulder close a little bit longer. You know, it might be out here a little bit more instead of, you know, at this point, we basically can't see your left shoulder. All right. Angle-wise, you know, nothing's showing up too bad for, like, injury. You know, you got a pretty good angle usually if we're, you know, really high up with our elbow or really far down. So you got a good spot for it. Now it's just a matter of locking in this front shoulder a little bit more to create that hip-shoulder separation. You know, we want our hips to start turning before that upper body does. You can see it's there a little bit, but if you can get that shoulder closed a little bit longer, get that glove out front, you're going to see through that release point, all right, you're doing good at staying through that back leg. Your back leg's not coming off the ground, but what you can see is you're starting to straighten up that front leg a little bit early, and you're starting to release the ball. Looks like we'll mark it about right there. All right, so there's your release. We'll mark your head too. All right. Actually, let's do it this way. We'll go. There's your release. There's your head. All right. And so what we'd want to try to see is at this spot, we want to try to see your head out over that front foot a little bit more. We want to try to see at this point a little bit more angle in that knee right here. And what that's going to get you to do, and we probably want to try to still see that glove a little bit more out here, is we want to try to create a little bit more angle, get down over that front foot. So now we're here, all right, our head's going to be out over that front foot. That's going to create a little bit more drive on the ball, a little bit more power, and then we're going to be releasing the ball out here. We're going to be releasing it farther out with more angle and with more power. So just try to work on getting down over that front foot a little bit more instead of kind of releasing the ball back over your hip somewhere, all right? So it's just all about using the leg, you know, using that lower body, using your hips to throw. You know, it looks like you got a pretty good understanding of everything. And really, all it is for you is just to clean up that initial start. Just get away from that, kicking that foot out. Try to think more about getting it in your hips, keeping your hips closed longer, and just kind of stay balanced. Stay a little bit more controlled over the sort of that start of that delivery. And then once you get that foot strike, you know, your arm's going to be able to get out in front over that front foot. You're going to be able to be in more control and staying back to sort of maximize all that power and everything. So anyways, hopefully you're able to see a few things and work on some stuff. Thanks again for making it out to camp. Hopefully you had a great time, and we look forward to seeing you again with ABC.